Hey, what's up everybody? It's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. Today, I have a quick update for you guys who use Oculus Go. Now, with the new firmware update just released a couple days ago, you can play up to 5.7K 360 or VR180 videos natively using the same Sideload techniques I show you in my old tutorials. Yes, it is 5.7K, not 4K, playback smoothly, but with a catch. I will show you the catch and how to render your GoPro Fusion 5.2K 360 video and the complete rendering workflow from the Zcam K1 Pro WonderStitch all the way to Oculus Go. Sideloaded. Let's get started. Facebook and Oculus really listen to their end users, which majority of them use GoPro Fusion or E360 VR right here to create 360 contents. Fusion can now capture 5.2K with the new Fusion Studio, and the E right here can capture 5.7K. The old Oculus Go firmware can only support 4K x 4K 30 frames per second video. Anything more than 4K in width will not play back smoothly. But with this new update, you can now drop 5.2K GoPro Fusion footage directly into the Oculus Go and it will play. But two things you need to pay attention. First, this will only work with footage with an aspect ratio of 2:1, which are these two resolutions for the best result. Second, it has to be H.264, not H.265. Well, you ask, how to generate this kind of resolution sizes in Adobe Premiere? Well, check out this tutorial for more detail. The newest Adobe Premiere support up to 16K H.264 render. So just render your GoPro Fusion with the original quality and resolution and attach -360 onto your output file name. Then just follow this tutorial on sideloading your video onto your Oculus Go. This is not only limited for monoscopic 360 videos. If you follow my VR180 guide and do your VR180 post-production in side-by-side format, you can also benefit from this resolution upgrade. Let's assume you capture your footage, your VR180 footage with super high resolution with the high quality Zcam K1 Pro camera. And here is the complete workflow from WonderStitch to Oculus Go. So now we are in Zcam WonderStitch. As you see right here, I have some footage I shot with a dancer dancing. As you see right here, I can scrub through it. The first thing is, if you need to use a WonderStitch, you need to pick the Zcam K1 Pro, which is the camera, and your serial number, which is the bottom of your camera, and then go ahead and browse the folder, and then Zcam will read the left and right eyes and showcase in here, as you see right here, and then you can pick where do you want to start to render and where's the end you want to render, as you see right here. Go ahead and pick a destination folder. And in here, which is one of the most important things. So the Zcam K1 Pro actually take a pretty high resolution. And I think it's up to 6K. But because the Oculus max resolution, as you see, I show it right there, is 5.7K. So the high of the footage is 2880. So it's not necessary to output 6K from the K1 Pro. Again, you can and then downscale it. But there is not much resolution increase in the end result. So in order to just increase the editing speed to process less footage, I will basically pick just 5.7K right here. So in the output format, make sure you pick VR180 Eagle Rectangular right here, not the mesh one. And then the layout is left and right, which is side by side. And then in codec and other very important setting right here, you should pick H.264, not 5, because it only work in H.264. And then in the bitrate, 160 should be good enough.
again, if you have GPU, using GPU render. And then switching left and right eye. No, I don't want to switch left and right eye. And other really important settings, smart align, which is a really special feature. And the only reason why I pick Zcam WonderStitch instead of Mystical VR for VR180 stitching, because Zcam have an internal algorithm to make sure that your alignment is perfectly on point, so your VR180 stereo look good. So make sure you pick this on, and then you can go ahead and stitch your preview. And you see the preview thing look correct, it's side by side, look really good. And then go ahead and just hit start. After we're done with Zcam, just go ahead and drop in the final rendering footage into Adobe Premiere. Let me go ahead and just mute it. And then on in here, you just do some basic editing. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick, I gotta render from here. And then she's dancing. By the way, if you want to see VR180, make sure that you pick the correct setting. As you see right now, it's not. It's Rego rectangular, but it's stereo side by side, and it's 180. Go ahead and hit OK. That should fix the issue. As you see right now, you see it's correctly. And then she's dancing. So by the way, this is a brand new video, music video I'm working on with a bunch of really good dancer. So it's gonna look amazing with the Zcam. As you see, it's VR180 footage. Take a look around. Amazing. So let's just pick a good frame right here when the dancer is really close to the camera. And then go ahead and hit render right here, export. So in here, make sure again, very important is H.264. And then you can use one of the brand new feature. Again, I'm on the brand new Adobe. If you're not on the brand new Adobe, you'll miss out. This version is actually very stable for VR immersive production. So I highly recommend it, just up to the newest version. I know people always worry about Adobe will crash for the newest version. You should wait on it, but not if you're working in immersive media. Because the team in Adobe is working very hard, doing the best they can do. If you're working in the VR world, I highly recommend it. Just update to the latest version so you can enjoy the newest feature. Like this one called Adaptive Match Source. So I want to have a high bitrate adaptive. So you will actually pick the good target bitrate for me, so I don't even need to think about it, and I just know that using that I will have the highest quality with the less file size. Great feature to have. And also right here is 5.7K, because that is what I want, 5.7K, and because hit match source well, 5.7K and 2880, and that is the format we need. It's the same format as the Yi 260 monoscopic, but here this is actually stereoscopic, it's just VR180. So one thing here, make sure that you check the video is VR and stereo is side by side. It's not top and bottom, it's not monoscopic, it's side by side. So make sure that is picked, and then you just go ahead and hit render. Okay, now the render is finished, and as you see the file here, and make sure that you have -180-3D as your final part of your file name. So that is the way Oculus Go know that is a 180 video and it's in VR and it's 3D stereoscopic. You can go ahead and play it if you want to. And then go ahead and plug in your Oculus Go, and after you allow Oculus Go to access to your computer, go ahead and click the VR headset right here. And just go ahead and drop the files in here. Then go ahead and put on your Oculus Go, hit gallery, and then just go ahead and hit internal storage. To find the video, it's right there, click that, play that, and there you go, you see the final output from the Zcam, and look amazingly in the Oculus Go headset in VR180 stereoscopic. And by the way, this is my brand new music video I'm working on, so if you want to check that out, don't forget to subscribe to my channel.
Thank you for watching this quick update on Oculus Go. The next video, we will compare the video quality between the Oculus Go and the brand new Vive Focus right here, and how to silo and achieve the best result in the brand new Vive Focus as well. So don't forget to subscribe to this channel for new releases, and give me a thumb up if you find this video helpful and you get to play higher quality video in your Oculus Go headset. And don't forget to share it to your friends who also own the Oculus Go or the HTC Vive. There are still seats left in my upcoming 360 masterclass, so sign up today if you are in Los Angeles, New York City, or Chicago. And I will see you next time.